Well, here's the question sent to CornyDriveThru@gmail.com from Richard in Eastbourne, UK.
Well, hello, Dick.
Hello, Jim and Brian. I'm relatively new to this podcast and have read Jim's dislike for Jake Roberts. Can you please explain why that is, please? Speaking of vaccinations, Jake Roberts.
Well, now, how has he picked up on my supposed dislike for Jake Roberts and not your absolute complete detestation and disdain for Jake Roberts?
Well, he was a good promo. I'll say some nice things.
I say lighthearted things about Jake and some of the antics that he's been involved in the past. And I've told the story on how he, I'm not the only person by any stretch of the imagination that he bailed on with no notice. But I haven't just dug in and said that Jake ought to be boiled in oil and have his fat sold for soap. I know there's quite a bit of steam between you and Mr. Roberts because of the way he treated Jerry Gray, a cancer patient who Jake owed a ton of money and refused to pay back.
For the record, Jake has screwed over multiple people I'm friends with.
I didn't say that.
From
that was
you
totally
to John Arezzi to Jerry Gray, everyone. I was at an autograph appearance with Jake Roberts in the summer of 93 that John Arezzi set up on the island at L&S Comics in North Merrick. And they had a line around the building. Kids and their moms all there on this Saturday morning to meet Jake the Snake. A little over a year off WWF TV, a few months off WCW TV, still in relatively okay shape. It's Jake the Snake. He showed up so fucked up, he couldn't lift his head up. There were kids. You should have seen the faces on these kids and their parents. You know who saved the day? The Power Twins. The world-famous Power Twins. They showed up, saw how fucked up Jake Roberts was, and decided they would be nice to people for a few minutes. And they start talking to people. It was a disaster. And it was just one of many disasters with Jake. It's what I witnessed. But he screwed over so many people I know. With that said, in the Randy Savage documentary, Nice Jake is funny to watch. Like the whole, when you know he's turning it on, you know, the whole nice guy, like, oh, I didn't see him do steroids, but I figure he did.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Manners.
Well, now let me ask you this. This is a brand new biography of Randy Savage. Jake was sitting down to do it. Could it have been, they started a year ago?
Okay. His hair, right?
His hair,
yeah.
It wasn't Bill Dundee black, but it was brown everywhere. Hair, beard, mustache, whatever. And now he's grayer than Gandalf. What? Did he just do that just to be on A&E, but he didn't give a fuck about Weekly on TNT? What happened there? It looked like Jake from 10 years ago.
I have no idea. He still sounds like, how does that happen? Him and Vince are the two guys that their voices have completely changed.
Well, I can guarantee you Vince's is not from smoking crack.
You guarantee this?
I guarantee that. See everything I left out there?
Yeah, you left out a lot.
See everything I left out? Vince's voice did not change from smoking too much crack.
So, to answer this question, are you denying? You're saying you have no problems at all with Jake Roberts?
No, I just said, how was it phrased? That I've your hatred for... I'm ambivalent either way as to whether Jake should be boiled in oil and have his fat sold for soap. It's not a fresh wound. We got past it. We got the belt back on the dirty white boy in Bluefield, West Virginia, and we moved on with that. So it was a pain in the ass having to ferry Jake's non-driver's license having ass around Stamford and Greenwich. Those times he was on the creative team because I was the one chosen to pick him up and drop him off.
If someone called you up, a friend of yours, and said, Jim, you can't talk me out of it. I'm promoting a wrestling show. Would you suggest booking Jake?
Well, now that doesn't make sense.
He's not wrestling.
Called me and said, you can't book me. You can't talk me out of it. I'm running a wrestling show and I'm going to book Jake the Snake. Well, already he's prepping. You can't talk me out of this. So why am I going to try? He was like, okay, it's your funeral.
All right.
If someone just said, I'm going to run a wrestling show, who should I book? I think Jake would probably be down in the 300 or 400s choice before, you know, right before Hitler, Saddam Hussein, and Twinkle Toes McFinger Bang.